Now, if you look in the Greek dictionary, the Muslims like Ahmadinejad and other Muslims have indicated that the word paraclete is an actual perversion of the word paraclete, which means the praised one. But if you look at the word in Greek, even the word that exists now in their gospel according to John, the word itself, its first and primary meaning, according to classical Greek lexicons, is the intercessor, al-mushaffi', the one who intercedes for a people. That is the maqam of Ahmad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That is his maqam in the Akhirah. He is Ahmad in the Akhirah because he is the intercessor of humankind. He intercedes for the believers. This is his maqam, alayhi salam. لَا يَشْفَعُ عَنْدُهُ إِلَّا بِإِذْنِي. No one intercedes in the presence of Allah except with his permission. And the first given permission to intercede is the Prophet ﷺ. Bani Israel, a group of them believed and a group of them disbelieved. But then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says an extraordinary thing. فَأَيَّدْنَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا عَلَىٰ عَدُوِّهِمْ. We gave strength and victory to those who believed of the Messiah, Ibn Maryam. Those who believed, we gave them victory over their enemies, and they became the Zahireen. In this verse, there are three verses in the Quran that are mentioned, very similar, Kafirun, Mushrikun. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, هو الذي أرسل رسوله بدين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله ولو كره الكافرون ولو كره المشركون. Three times it's mentioned in the Quran. From the Muslim perspective, there are three false or altered ways of worshiping Allah. There's the way of the Nasara, there's the way of the Yahud, and there's the way of the Mushrikeen. This is how Islam has demarcated beliefs. Islam will be manifest over these three traditions, as it has in the past, and it will so towards the end of time. The word that they, أصبحوا الظاهرين, they became manifest. This did not happen in the lifetime of Isa alayhi salam. If you look at the history of Isa alayhi salam, his prophetic movement and his prophetic message was not fully implemented. A group of Bani Israel believed in him, but a group of them plotted with the Romans against his people, and eventually they were actually massacred and wiped out in 60 AD. And this is all, you can study this in the history. There were a group of early Christians called the Ebionites, and they were a Semitic Christian. They were Jewish people who had embraced the message of Isa alayhi salam. They were waiting for somebody to come after. And this is in their books. Fascinating information of the Dead Sea Scrolls. If you know about this, the Dead Sea Scrolls were some books that some poor Bedouin people found in the caves in Qumran, just outside near the Dead Sea. And they went and sold them to some Armenian traders. And the Armenians sold them to some Orthodox priests who sold them. They're all out for money. Everyone's trying to make more money. And they eventually got sold to the Catholic Church. The Nag Hammadi Library was a library that was discovered in 1947. The Nag Hammadi Library, within less than 3 years, was completely translated and published. Unlike the Dead Sea Scrolls, over 40 years have passed since they were discovered, and they have yet to be fully disclosed to the scholars. There have been major complaints by biblical scholars in universities all over the world that the Israeli government, in complicity with the Catholic Church, did not allow these manuscripts to be examined by scholars. And we have to ask why. Why is it that the Nag Hammadi Library that was found in Egypt, which was actually a much larger volume of work, was translated within 3 years and published for the scholars all over the world to examine and look at, which included Apocrypha, it included the Gospel according to Thomas, it included the infancy Gospels, which confirm stories in the Quran that they did not have sources for. These people, the Dead Sea Scrolls, are part of a movement, some say from the Essenes, but there were a group of Christians that were Jewish people following the way of Isa and waiting for a prophet to come after Isa alayhi salam. If you look in the Gospels, the remnants of them, there's much talk about the kingdom of God is at hand. And the kingdom of God that's being talked about in the Gospels was not the next world. It was in this world. It's very clear in the Gospels that the kingdom of God is at hand and it's in this world. The verse in the Quran, according to our ulama, the commentary of this verse, those people that were given victory over their enemies, in other words, over those who rejected the Isa alayhi salam, were the Muslims. And Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu is the leader of those Muslims that came into Palestine and liberated Palestine. They confirmed the message of Isa alayhi salam to the Christians and confirmed the truth of Isa's mission to the Jews of that time. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala manifested them over the enemies of Isa alayhi salam and over those who had falsely interpreted the teachings of Isa alayhi salam. And so this is one of the gifts that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave this ummah, is to clarify for the other peoples who Isa was, which is one of the wisdoms of why the Messiah is in the Muslim tradition, although it's not mentioned in the Quran explicitly, nor is it mentioned in any Sahih Hadith explicitness. There are many weak Hadiths about the Mahdi, but there are many Hadiths also, the Sahih Hadith, that indicate that Isa alayhi salam will come at the end of time. Imam al-Tahawi mentions this in his Aqidah. It was considered to be the acceptable position of the people of Sunnah and Jama'ah. Although there have been Muslims historically, including Ibn Khaldun, that rejected the idea of a Mahdi, believe they were fabricated hadiths. There have been these differences of opinion. But the dominant opinion of the people of Sunnah and Jama'ah is that Isa alayhi salam and the Mahdi would come at very similar times, the Mahdi preceding them, in the hadith that's again not a clear hadith. كيف أنتم إذا نزل فيكم عيسى بن مريم وإمامكم منكم. How will you be when Isa alayhi salam comes again and your imam is from you? The indication there is Imam al-Mahdi. And he comes to Bayt al-Maqdis and kills the Masih al-Dajjal. Isa alayhi salam will kill the Masih al-Dajjal in Bayt al-Maqdis according to these hadiths. Now the hadiths which are called Hadith al-Malahim, Hadith al-Fitan, Hadith Akhir al-Zaman, there's been a book published, it's a translation of Ibn Kathir's book from al-Bidayah wa Nihaya, which is his tariq, called The Signs of the End of Time. And Muslims very interested in this subject. These signs of the end of time, some of them are very difficult to discern. Literally, what is being said? What is the meanings? Part of the difficulty, I believe, is that the Prophet ﷺ was speaking according to the understanding of the people of his age about things that they had no frames of reference for. There were no frames of reference. These people did not understand airplanes. They did not understand phones, cellular phones, and beepers and these type of things. It's very difficult. There's a hadith that says, in the end of time, and this is a sound hadith, in the end of time, a man would leave his house. يخرج المرء من بيتي فتخبره فخذه بما أحدث أهله من بعده. A man will leave his house and his thigh will tell him what was happening in his house after he left the house. Now we know in the language of the Arabs will call something by a thing that it's attached to. In other words, if somebody had a phone on their thigh, then the Arabs could actually say, أخبرته فخذه. And he means the thing that was on his thigh. This is very common in the Arabic language, to call a thing by a thing that is near, or to call a hole by the part. اشتعل رأسه شيبا. His head, it literally says his head turned gray in the Quran, Zakariya alayhi salam. But it wasn't his head that turned gray, it was his hair. But the Quran uses the whole to indicate the part. So this is part of the Arabic language. So he also said that a man, the shiraku na'lihi satukallimuhu, the strap, the thong of his sandal will speak to him. He said that the jamadat, that inanimate things would speak. There's a saying, it's not a hadith, but it's mentioned centuries ago in the books. إِذَا نَطَقَ الْحَدِيدُ وَسَادَ الْعَبِيدُ وَقَرُبَ إِذَا نَطَقَ الْحَدِيدُ وَسَادَ الْعَبِيدُ وَقَرُبَ الْبَعِيدُ فَانْتَذَرَ الْوَعِيدُ. This is something I've seen a long time ago. When metal speaks, And the slaves, the low people rule. And this is from that, they're taking it, drawing it from the hadith, this proverb. They're drawing it from the hadith. Because the Prophet ﷺ said, in the end of time, the lowest people would become the rulers. The lowest people would become the rulers.